your name, your rule and reign, never being defeated anymore. We're waging war.
Be my sword, be my shield, as we claim the victory.
Hello, hello, hello. Happy self-care Saturday. Happy June 10th. Listen, this is a victory day. Come through, Jesus. This is like my theme song now. Like, hello, hello, hello. This is my best part. I love this part. Come through now. All right. Hello, hello, hello. Happy self-care Saturday. Happy self-care Saturday. And happy June 10th. I know this is a special, special day for us, and the day of freedom, the day when some things took place many, many years ago that we get to celebrate and walk in on today. And so originally I wanted to do a quick live on tomorrow, but since the weather and everything changed or whatever, I'm like, you know what? Let me just go ahead and just do this today. I was supposed to be out with my son and his friends. We were supposed to go to the pool again today. And I was supposed to be enjoying some sun, right? And they messed around and the rain started to come. So I'm like, you know what? Let me just go ahead and do my live today and then I can make it up to him on tomorrow. With his daddy on Father's Day. How about that? Okay, a two-for-one deal. Praise Jesus. All right, so hello, hello, hello. My name is Tanika. I am a marriage and wife coach / wedding officiant. And I'm super excited about today's live. I title it, Go Through. Go Through, Wife, Go Through. There is a reasoning behind your hard season in your marriage. It is for a reason. It is for a reason. And today I wanted to kind of briefly talk about that. I want to share a little transparency a little bit and talk about that on today and get into that a little bit. So I wanted to say a quick prayer before we get started. I've been feeling led a lot to say prayers more now before going into the message. I feel like God is saying in this season, this is the season of wisdom. This is the season of wisdom. And so I'm really trying to be obedient and shift as he lead me to shift. So Father, we bless you on today. We love you. We thank you, God, for your amazing grace and mercy. I give you all the praise, glory, and honor. I thank you, Jesus, for this time, this opportunity, for this day. I pray, Father, that you will wash us with your son, Jesus' precious blood, and help us, God, as we continue to go through, as wives continue to go through their season of hardship, Lord. I pray that you would give each wife what they need. I pray for understanding to come forward through this message and through this video. I pray for change to take place, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for this message to touch and hit and get to each wife that you want to receive this message, God, on today in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, as I praise your holy and mighty name, I give you all the praises, glory, and honor. May there be no backlash on this video. May it be covered with the blood of Jesus. And that every word go forth and will not return back void. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, amen. Alrighty, so, like I mentioned, I want to talk to my wives today about going through, all right? going through your heart season in your marriage. And I hope it brings some type of encouragement, some type of confirmation. I hope it brings enlightenment. I hope it brings forth change more than anything. That's one of my goals. It brings forth change and push wives to get to a position and a place where they make a decision, okay? Push you to make a decision on today. I've shared before the story of when God revealed to me about me carrying the Deborah anointing. I've shared that story before. And I actually, I don't have my book on me. But it's the little wife manual book I've been sharing. I actually put it in there. It's part of the wife movement. And this is actually where the wife movement was birthed. And so one day at work, this was like during the time me and my husband, I think it was, we were separated during this time. But even before this time, before my husband and I were separated, I remember being home in my bed. And I don't remember what year in my marriage it was. I want to say it probably was a year between 5 and 7. Okay, it was probably between year 5 and 7 that I felt like the Lord had spoke to me one night in my bed. And he told me, I just heard him come out and say to me, "You're going to be like a Deborah. You're going to be like a Deborah." I was like a Deborah. Now, mind you, I had been working in the church. I had been in church all my life, but I've been working in the church for a while. And so I knew the Deborah story. I knew Deborah's story. I remember hearing, you know, messages about it. I remember hearing God's word about it. I knew what Deborah's story was. And when I heard God say that, I was like, And I rolled right on over. I rolled right on over like I didn't even hear what he said, okay? And so years later, after that, like I said, after I ignored what he had told me, I was at work, and my background is medical, and so I was in the lab, and one of the guys that was there came into the office, and he also, you know, was a man of God, and he was, talking. We had been in conversation before, but this time he came and he was like, "Hey, Deborah." I was like, "Excuse me." He was like, "Hey, prophetess." I said, "Prophetess, I rebuke you." Because first of all, anybody got time for that, all right? And I was like, "What you talking about, sir?" He said, "Oh, I just thought you already knew that you carried the Deborah anointing." I was like, "How you knew that? Who told you that?" And so he was just talking just to be talking or whatever, but he had no idea that the Lord had already talked to me and, you know, about that, you know. And so when he said that, it was like, what in the what? And it was like God brought it back up again. It was almost like God's like, "Yeah, you thought I had forgot, right? You thought I had forgot." And so when he said that to me or whatever, it made me go back to like look her story up again, like start doing some research, start, you know, going back over, you know, what the Deborah story was about, what her anointing was. You know, I start like really, really studying her in that time. And by that time, my husband and I, we were separated, okay? And so I never understood why God allowed me to go through so much in my marriage. I could not understand it. I literally felt like I was being punished for something, okay? I literally felt like I was being punished for something. Year after year and month after month and day after day and moment after moment, it felt like I felt like I was in hell. If I could describe hell, that was me. That's what I felt like I was in the early stages in my marriage. I really felt like I was in hell. All right. And like I said, I went to church. I was in the church faithfully. And it's like I got some relief, but I didn't get like enough relief. You know, it's like I started, I would get something to hold me and, you know, a stick or whatever. And it was like by the time Wednesday came, I was like in straight anxiety mode again. Like I didn't have enough. And so I was like, why do I feel like I have to go through so much? Or why am I going through so much in my marriage? I prayed, I cried, I moaned, I groaned. I mean, a lot.
I complain. I talk plenty of trash because I ain't gonna do this. I am not gonna do this. This is what I'm not gonna do. I mean, I did that a lot, okay? I talk trash. I wasted time sharing a lot of my stories, a lot of my sob stories to different individuals, to different people who did not understand me or did not understand where I was coming from. A lot of times I would share with people who had no idea of, you know, what God was doing in my life. And I think God intended for it to be that way, you know, because I was looking for my answers, like hoping that I could find my answers in some of these people that I was sharing my stories with. And, you know, sometimes when you have a person that, you know, maybe going through something as well, or maybe, you know, they marry, you marry, you know, we can talk about marriage stuff or whatever, but that's not necessarily always the case. It's not because both of y'all are married that y'all necessarily understand each other's story, you know? Sometimes God have this person on a certain path, sometimes God have this person on a certain path. And so I just think God really just kept confusion in that for a reason. I really feel like all of that was part of his plan. And then a lot of times when I would share my story with different ones, I felt like they wasn't really like being authentic. I felt like they were just being nosy. And that's why I feel like, and I share it with all the time, make sure whoever is in your inner circle. Now, I had, on one hand, I had like a few that I could say was, you know, genuine, was real. But then I had some was like, you just being nosy. You just trying to be nosy. And that's why I always share it wise. You know, you be real careful who you allow in your inner circle and who you share your marriage information with, because a lot of people cannot handle your story. Okay. A lot of people cannot handle what God is doing in your marriage or with you. Okay. I walked in selfishness. I shut down. I rebelled against God. Okay. I rebelled against God by not taking hold of my assignment seriously. Listen, like I told you, when God came to me during those years, I was like, nope, nope, nope. Because I knew Deborah's story. I knew her story. And I was like, no, I didn't want to do that. That's not what I feel like I'm supposed to do in my life, you know? And so I remember plenty of times, many times, God will whisper in my ears and ask me the same question every time. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? And I remember this one time when me, my husband, and kids, we were on vacation. And we was on vacation having a good old time at first. And then the next thing I know, man, the evil one had done came through. And my husband and me, we had done got into our argument. He had done took off his wedding ring and threw it across the field. I was like, what in the world? And that was one time I remember hearing from God just as clear. And God said to me, are you ready? Are you ready? And so at first when God would ask me those questions, I was like, nope, I got it, God. Nope, I got it, God. I was so naive. All right. I was so naive and I did not understand all the different things that, you know, God was trying. He was showing me that I needed his help. It was almost like God was allowing me to go through these hard times so that I can come to him. He wanted me to come to him, but I kept on saying, nope, I got a God. Nope, I got a God. And I ain't have nothing, okay? I didn't have nothing. But after enough bumps and bruises, I finally realized I needed God's help. After going through some hard, hard times and seasons, after, you know, my mouth was just like dry up with fussing and cussing and preaching. And I mean, I did it all. I did it all. And I was tired of that because it was like, that wasn't working, all right? That wasn't working. I was like, why is that working? I seen this happen in other people's marriages and it worked. Like, it used to, like, be a shutdown. But when it came down to me, it wasn't working. It didn't work, all right? But it wasn't until 10 years. I've been married 16 and a half years. So 10 years into my marriage, I realized God was going to have his way. God was going to have his way, okay? And in my marriage, I felt like death. I feel like my marriage was death. I'm like, this is the holding pin until God come and judgment day come, all right? I that's how I felt. That's the things that I felt like I was going through. And I remember making a decision. I said, well, if I'm going to die here in my marriage, at least, or I might as well die doing what God has asked me to do. okay? I might as well die doing what God has asked me to do, because I got tired of fighting. I got tired of fighting with him. I got tired of mostly fighting with myself, because I could hear God clearly. I could hear God say, not today, don't bother him. I could hear God say, leave him alone. I could hear God say, let me handle this. Let me fight this for you today. I would hear God say that. I'd be like, no, I got this, God. And I was crazy. I was not wise. I was not wise at all. I was a foolish wife, especially when I heard God talk to me and tell me, let me handle this, or let me do this for you, or let me, you know, I heard him. I wasn't in church, or I wasn't involved with God enough. I wasn't in relationship with him, or I didn't pray. I was in church. I was a Sunday school teacher. I used to teach the elementary kids. So I was in church. I heard from God very clearly. I heard him very plain. I used to even go to, I was signed up for different like marriage classes, and I would go to these marriage classes, not necessarily speaking, but I would go to the classes and listen to them. And so I was very aware of what I was supposed to do, and I was not following. All right. I was not following. But then I met Psalms 119, 71. All right, and it says, it was good for me that I was afflicted. It was good for me to be afflicted so that I might learn your decrees. My suffering was good for me because it taught me to pay attention to God's decrees. It taught me to pay attention to God's decree. The days of terror, and I'm going to explain why I use the word terror. The days of terror in my marriage has been the best thing that has happened to me. The days of terror. And when I use the word terror, I want you to understand, I have been visited on numerous occasions from the evil one, okay, in his crew. I have been visited on numerous occasions, especially when I really made a decision to say, okay, I'm going to submit and actually do what God is asking me to do. I'm going to really submit and really do what God is asking me to do in this season of my life, okay? And so the days of terror in my marriage has been the best things that happened to me. It has strengthened me and helped me and prepared me to be the Coach T that I am, all right? So I am compassionate about marriages being restored. I am compassionate about marriages being restored and having a happy endings. But I am in love with wives who come to realization about God's plan for them. Like that right there is like, I'm in love with the wife who comes to realization that I cannot do this on my own. I need God's help. I cannot fight this marital battle on my own. I need God's help. And one of the things I encourage my wives anytime I sit down and have a session with them is, don't stop listening to God. Continue to go to God and let him walk with you on this journey, because God is doing something. I know it seems hard. I know it seems like, man, will this ever end? God is doing something, okay? He is doing something. Your marriage is the beginning place, okay? It's the beginning place. It's your training ground for the next assignment, because there is a next after that hardship in your marriage. A lot of people think that once this hardship is over, okay, we're going to rejoice, everything's going to be great and grand, and that's it. No. There's a next part to that, and then the next part, and then the next part. There's levels to this thing, okay? Once your marriage is restored and everything is back to its place, you still have work to do, okay? That's when the real work starts. Right now, during this fragile season, during this hardship, this is your training ground, okay? This is your training ground. But your next is greater. The reason it's so important for you, wife, to keep going through, is because on the other side of your painful marriage, on the other side of what you're going through in your marriage, the answer to your next is there. Your calling is there. Your purpose is there. What God will have you to do for him on earth is there. So it's important, wife, for you to continue go through, even though it's a hard season of your marriage, okay? God finally reveals to you the person he created you to be. Not just in your marriage, but also for him and what you will be doing for him here on earth. All right? I, myself, a lot of people say, you know, I have like, you know, maybe an apostle over me, or I have like different people that, you know, covering me, or I have different people that, you know, are praying for me in this area. And I had one person, my coach, I call her Auntie Jerry, but she was my coach. I had her and God. Okay, and I had a lot more of God than her, but I feel like a lot of times God would tell her, let me handle this. So I had her and God. And God, I feel like, literally trained me in my marriage. He literally trained me. Once I finally stopped fighting and stopped being rebellious against my assignment, God was the one who finally said, okay, I'm going to help you walk through this. And I'm going to walk with you through this, okay? After years of studying the story of Deborah, I finally understood my anointing. And that is one of the things that I bring to wife's attention. You have to understand, wife, it's not just about you dealing with this hard part in your marriage and going through this hard thing with your husband. You have to understand that God is building you, strengthening you, creating you, molding you, training you for something that he wants you to do. And it's much bigger. Your husband, your marriage, that's just the training place, okay? That's just the beginning stages. I am an intercessor for marriages, and especially for wives. I stand in the gap and speak against adultery and unrighteous living. I help wives rescue their marriages, their husbands, by showing her how to rescue and save herself first. There is no way, wife, you can be what you need to be for your husband, for your marriage, to your children, without first making sure that you are everything God has created you to be first, okay? God is trying to do something to you. And I know a lot of times when you going through that, you don't see nothing else. You just see that one thing, because the enemy wants you to focus just on all the negative. He wants you to focus on just the negative things that are happening. But there is so much God is releasing in that time. There's so much God is trying to show you and walking you through during that time. And so I just really, really want God, really want wives to understand that your marriage pain, your hardship in your marriage, it's not just about you and your husband. Your hardship in your marriage, your pain in your marriage, is about what God is trying to get through you, okay? It's what he's trying to get through you. I help wives to get in alignment with God's word about her marriage and her husband, and then I support her on her journey until she can stand on her own, all right? One of the ways I help wives is by enforcing the importance of self-care. All right, this is part of my Her Buoyancy Boost program, because she is not available to be what she needs to be to her husband and children, marriage, or anything else until she first prioritizes herself. Okay, and I want to just go into a little bit more detail about why self-caring for yourself is not always just juice and eating berries, or going to get your nails done, or going to get your hair did, or, you know, going to your favorite restaurant. Like, all those things are great and wonderful, and you should do those things, but that's not the only thing you should be doing. And that's why I don't just say self-care, but the program that I have is self-care and soul care. I help wives to prioritize self-care and soul care, because yes, when you look your best, you feel your best. You know, if you look a certain way, if you put yourself together, yeah, you're going to feel better about yourself. If you walk around in your PJs and a scarf on your head, that's how you're going to be feeling. But if you go and be like, okay, I'm going to go get my nails did today, I'm going to get my hair did, you're going to feel a whole lot good about yourself. I used to share all the time how, I know y'all probably been seeing, like, Coach Sheedy went from braids to a little ponytail. Yes, I changed it up a little bit because it's hot outside and nobody got time for that, okay? But I used to wear my hair in like short pixie cuts, and I absolutely love my hair being short, but it was a lot of maintenance. But I feel like one of the things that God allowed me to do in my marriage, during my hardship, during my hard times, was, you know, he showed me how to self-care for myself. And so I would go get my hair did every single week. Like, that was my, like, if I didn't get my hair did, it wasn't going to work. Like, nothing was going to happen. Okay. But I knew that I had my appointment set every Saturday. I would go get my hair did. And that was like how I started off my weekend, got things started. I was able to move. I was looking forward to my hair day because I knew hair day, everything was going to be all right on hair day. Okay. And so I'm not saying that you're not supposed to self care for yourself in that sense. I would go do hair day. I would go to the mall and shop. I would go out to eat with some friends. I'll do like a brunch date. Sometimes I'll do like a late dinner date. I would go and hang out. Like, Saturday was my day, okay? Like, Saturday was my day to move around and get some things, you know, going. And so I planned for that. Like, I knew the weekend was coming. Like, I would look forward to Saturday because I knew Saturday, when Saturday got here, baby, some things was going to change. It was all about my day, all right? And so this is why, one of the reasons why I tell wives, it's important that you make sure that you are self-caring for yourself, okay? That you are self-caring for yourself. Self-caring for yourself is taking some time to work on you, okay? But the other side to it is the soul care. It's the soul care. And this is why Her Bonus Boost is self-care. It's a self-care and soul care program. Because you also want to self-care for yourself by working on you mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. All those play a major, major role in prioritizing you and helping you to be your best for you first, and then your husband and your children and your family and whatever else you have to do. I remember when me and my husband were separated, and I used to do it when he was here too, but I actually signed up for a program, and I went to, it was 2 days out of the week I used to go. And man, when I tell you, I was looking forward to going. I'm not like really like the exercising type of person. Like, I used to like get videos and do like the black girl workout. I used to do the black girl workout. I used to do like little stuff in the neighborhood, walk around, whatever. But these programs that I had signed up to, it held me accountable. One, because they was getting my money. And then two, it gave me it was like an outlet for me. I used to go and, you know, be part of this class. It was like a exercise class. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. And wife's got to get to that place where it's not just about, you know, the nails and the hair. Yes, that's part of it. But then you want to also do some physical work on yourself. You want to also, my thing was, I'm not gonna sit in this house when me and my husband separated and blow up and be a big old pig when he come back home. And that was one of the things that used to always run in my mind. I used to always be like, when my husband come back home, I don't want him to come and see me, oh, I'm all out of shape and all, you know, looking all kind of crazy. No, I want him to come back home to a fine, sexy wife, okay? Because I was working on me. And I feel like God gave me that time when we was apart to work on me. And so I did. I had lost a lot of weight going through those programs. And I mean, it was a really nice out. And so it's important for wives to take care of themselves physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, okay? And that's what Her Buoyancy Boost does for you, okay? That's what Her Buoyancy Boost does. Buoyancy Boost help you in those areas, okay? Help you in all those areas. And so I ask these questions. Do you need a bestie? Do you need a bestie? Sign up for your Her Buoyancy Boost. Do you need someone to understand your marital pain? Sign up for your Her Buoyancy Boost. Do you need someone who speaks your language about a dead marriage, but you feel so deep down inside that you're supposed to stay in this dead marriage? Sign up for Her Buoyancy Boost, okay? Do you feel stuck in your toxic marriage and you want to find a way out? Sign up for Her Buoyancy Boost. Is your husband addicted to drugs, alcohol, and women? Sign up for Her Buoyancy Boost, all right? God may be just training you during this season. He's training you during this season for the anointing, for something bigger, for what he wants to do for you later. I know it seems hard right now, but I want to encourage my wives to keep going through, okay? God is definitely handing out promotions in this season, and I don't want wives to miss it, all right? I do not want wives to miss it. It's important, wives, that you get busy about what it is that God wants you to do. Don't so much look at your marriage as, oh, he's doing what every other man does in the world, or he's doing this or he's doing that. I always tell wives to, you know, kind of like look at it from two different lenses, because you may look at it this way, but God is trying to do something totally different on this side, okay? I want to leave you with this. One of my clients asked me, why do you always give away gifts you know, with your program. Why is giving away gifts in your program so important to you? Isn't just coaching your wives, isn't that just enough? And the answer comes from here before I get into detail about it. It comes from John 14:27, and it says, I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Unless you have walked and lived through a hard marriage, you wouldn't understand why the gifts are so important. You wouldn't understand that. Some days in your marriage and on your journey to trying to get to a better place, you literally feel like you can't do nothing. Like, you literally feel like this is the end of life for me. Like, this is it. You literally feel like you there's no way God is going to be able to save this marriage. There's no way God is going to be able to pull this back together. There's no way I'm going to be able to, you know, to get through this or whatever. You don't have no hope. You feel hopeless. You feel, you know, you just feel like you just done. And it's something about the gift that makes it a little bit better. All right. It's something about the gift that makes it a little bit better. Now, by nature, I'm a giver at heart. I think that was embedded in me. When I was a child. I seen my mom give people all the time. It was her way of serving people, okay? And so I think I kind of got the gift given from her. But in my days of going through as a wife, I remember the resources given to me, the books, the words that were shared. I write down everything. Anytime somebody gave me some kind of advice about my marriage, or I heard a message in church, or I watched something on TV because I kept the Word Network on. Anytime I had any of those things going on, I made sure that I write it down. Messages, those things I was able to reflect on and go back to. Those things gave me hope in the middle of the night when Satan and his agents visit me constantly, playing tricks in my mind about my marriage over and over and over again. I used to have books on my bed. I used to have audios playing. I used to have the Word Network TV on. I would be all oiled up. I had crosses all around my house. The oil crosses all around my house. Like, I was ready, because the enemy, and this is why I say self-care and soul care is so important, and why I emphasize it in my program, and why I encourage wives to make sure they do it. Because you go through, once you get past, okay, I'm gonna make a decision to stand for my marriage. You have to understand, first comes the pain, the hardship, the oh my God, this is what happened to me, this is what, you know, he did, this, that, and the other. That's the first part. Do I make a decision to stay or go or whatever? Once you get to a place of, okay, I know I'm supposed to stay. Now, what do I do next? Okay, I need God to help me in this. If I'm going to stay in this, I need God to help me in this. Now, what I do next? So then you make a decision to stay. You do what God asks you to do. You have to understand, once you do what God is asking you to do, that's when the terror is going to come. Okay, that's when the terror is going to come. Because now the enemy knows that, okay, you're no longer on his team anymore. Now you're doing things God way. And because you're doing things God way, his plan is to terrorize you. His plan is to shut you down. His plan is to come and aggravate you night and day until you get to a place of stopping, because you are in a spiritual battle. And a lot of times people think that marriage is just a natural thing. It is not. It's not just a natural thing. It is also spiritual. And there is a lot of spiritual warfare that takes place for a person who's trying to make a decision whether or not I should stay in my marriage or should I leave my marriage, okay? And so once you make a decision to stay in your marriage and stand for your marriage and start interceding for your marriage and go through what you have to go through, it's a process to that, okay? It's a process to that. And so the enemy did that with me a lot. He did that with me a lot. And so one of the things I was most helpful for was all the different resources that I had available at hand. Because, and this was why I go back to the church. The church is a place for you to begin. It's like, let me give it to you like this. Like I said, I always try to use my experience as a medical, working in the medical field. Working in the medical field, you have the primary and you have a specialist. All right, you have a primary, you have your specialist. So for your primary, you can pretty much go to the primary for anything, right? You can go to the primary for anything. But let's just say, for instance, okay, the primary would say, okay, well, we feel like you may need a biopsy did for whatever. They're going to send you to that biopsy specialist or whoever that was, you know, OBGYN, where you need to go to a ear, nose, and throat place or whatever your situation is. They can only do so much at the primary care place. And once they send you to, once the primary care place refer you on to somewhere else, then you go to your specialty, and from your specialty, you can get into things a little deeper. That is what I would compare the church to. And then once you go to the church, and they're gonna do what they can do for you, but sometimes you need something a little bit more intensive. You need something a little bit more intensive. The church is a starting place for wives who are going through hard times, who are going through hard seasons, who are going through something. But sometimes your struggle is a little bit more intense. And when it gets to that place, you need something. You need a specialist. And that's where Coach T comes in at. That's where her buoyancy boost comes in at, okay? And so having the resources available to me, because I couldn't always get up in the middle of the night and call my pastor, or I couldn't get up and call my coach even. So having those resources available to me, it gave me it was like a relief for me, okay? I had books I can refer to. I had my, you know, different things I can go back to, you know, things I wrote down and highlighted. This is why the fasting and praying is so important in this season. I had different things that I could go back to, and it kind of helped me on until I got a chance to talk to my coach. It helped me on because the pastor in the church, and I'm not saying that they're limited. There are a lot of things that they have available for you. It's a lot of things that they have available for you, but I do believe God has also put other places in hand for you to get that intensiveness. And a lot of times people stop at the church because they're not willing to invest in what they really need. And sometimes what you really need is somebody to walk with you on your journey, okay? And so that is one of the reasons why I give gifts. I give gifts so when you're not able to speak necessary to your coach, you have a resource. You have something that you can go back to. You have something that you can go, you can get to. But one of the benefits of my program is you have access to me 24/7. Once you join in, you have access to me 24/7. Once you complete the program, you have access to me unlimited. Okay. And that's one of my benefits because of that reason. So you may send me an email at, you know, 2 o'clock in the morning. And then I might get up in the middle of the morning before I pray or whatever, 5 o'clock, and I see your email and I respond to it, okay? That is one of the benefits of having a coach, okay? And having a coach. And that is one of the benefits and one of the gifts that I give to my wives and why the gifting is important to me, all right? And so the enemy is going to come for you. He came for me a lot. One time he tried to suffocate me, I felt myself like fighting, trying to wake up. And when I finally woke up, my ring, which I never take my ring off, my ring was on the side of my pillow. Okay. It was on the side of my pillow. All right. I know that the enemy fought me a lot because he did not want me to get to this place. I understand it now. All right. But he's a liar and the truth ain't in him. All right. He's a liar and the truth is not in him. Why? The enemy doesn't want you to get to the place God is taking you either, okay? The enemy doesn't want you to get there, but you got to stand up and be bold as a lion and refuse to quit. I fought a lot of principalities to get to where I'm at, okay? I fought a lot of principalities. I came up against a lot of his agents, and I'm not saying that it stops. What I'm saying is because you fought those things, you recognize it, and you know what it is, and you know, and you will learn. You will learn how to fight for your marriage during that time, okay? So when I show up on lives, a lot of times people think I'm just showing up. No, I'm showing up 100 because I know what I went through to get here, all right? When I tell you serious inquiries only, I'm serious about that because this is a serious battle that's taking place in marriages, and the enemy is trying to he's trying to cut it off. He's trying to stop it. He don't want it to continue, all right? And so if you have not already signed up for your Her Buoyancy Boost, I want to encourage you, wife. You do not have to walk in this alone. I want you to sign up for your Her Buoyancy Boost. You can sign up at www.marriagechroniclesbytanika.com. Sign up for your free consultation and let me help you on your journey, all right? Don't stop going through. It is a reason for your hardship. It is a reason for your trial. It is a reason for your, you know, your hard time in your marriage. God is training you, preparing you, anointing you with what he wants you to do for this world. I would have never thought in a million years that I would have finally agreed to the Deborah anointing, but I have accepted it wholeheartedly now, and I walk in it, and I do not take it for granted, all right? And so I want you to sign up for your Her Buoyancy Boost too in this hour, God, in this hour, wise, so you can get what God wants you to get in this season, okay? It's recovery time. God is saying it's time to walk in your freedom, receive what it is that he wants you to have. Her Buoyancy Boost is a spiritual and marriage investment. But when I tell you, it is so worth the investment. All right? So sign up today at www.marriagechroniclesbytanika.com. Listen, wise, do something for yourself that you enjoy doing. Happy Self-Care Saturday and enjoy this June 10th day. Blessings.